As the New York Rangers look to find their new head coach, John Hines has come out as the potential favorite to get the job of the New York Rangers' next head coach. And as a Rangers fan, I don't understand this at all. It makes no sense at all. You fired Gerard Gallant for a guy who had just not been a good coach at the NHL level. He was an AHL head coach for a few years, for 6 years, or for 5 years, 1 year of being an assistant coach. He's had like multiple years of being a coach at the NHL level, like 8 years. He has a 4-15 record in the playoffs. He has been there 4 different postseasons and has never won a playoff round. His overall record in the regular season is 284 wins, 254 losses, and 63 OT losses. So he doesn't have that great of a regular season record. You know, he's made the playoffs a decent amount of times, but he has not, like I said, won anything. I mean, he's made the playoffs 4 out of 8 years, and he's never won a playoff round, though. And actually, one of the years was like the qualifying round in that COVID year, so wasn't even really playoffs. So honestly, I don't like this move at all. If the Rangers do end up going with him, I will not be happy, because you had guys like Spencer Carberry, who I would have much rather get, even Jay Leach, go with a nice young option, potential with some high upside or something like that. And then you've also got a guy like Peter Laviolette, even, who is a decent veteran coach who has won an AHL championship, the Calder Cup. He's won a Stanley Cup, and he's also made the finals 2 other times. You know, 3 times total, he made the Stanley Cup finals with 3 different teams, and he's won it once. So that's not bad at all. He's made the playoffs like a ton of times. He has way more experience and just a way better coach overall. And I just don't get the John Hines thing. I really don't. Like, he was fired from the Predators this year, and he got fired from there. And then the Rangers and Chris Drury want to interview him, and they interviewed him twice, apparently. We've got some news from, like, Elliot Friedman on the, like, their the Jeff Merrick show. And, I mean, they were kind of talking. It seems weird, but it really is. It seems like it's likely, potentially likely, that the Rangers could hire John Hines. So this is per Elliot Friedman on the Jeff Merrick show. It appears Hines is a leading candidate to get the job. There seems to be a feeling at the combine that Hines has a great shot at it, Friedman said. I do believe they had another interview with Hines this week. So it sounds like they've interviewed him twice. So that means he is one of like the guys at the final stage to get the job. And it seems like they've interviewed him twice already at the combine or whatever. And it just, I don't like this move. I really don't like this move at all. This is not the move I was hoping to hear. I was at this point, I wanted Carberry originally. Then he went to the Capitals. At this point now, I just kind of want Peter Laviolette or Jay Leach. And at this point, it seems like it might be Hines. And I would not be happy with that at all. He just does not seem like a good coach. Has never won a playoff round. And that's the thing big with me is, I want a guy, if we're not going for a guy who has never coached the NHL before, like a Jay Leach or obviously like a Spencer Carberry, who have been like an AHL coach, or like AHL head coaches, ECHL head coaches, like coached at like junior levels and stuff, as well as been like assistant coaches at the NHL level. If we're going to go for a guy like that, like a good young guy, I would just rather go with Peter Laviolette, who's won cups, won a Calder Cup, been to the finals a ton of times, has a ton of playoff experience, has won a ton of the playoffs, and overall is just a solid like veteran coach. Then a guy like John Hines, who's been in the league 8 years, made the playoffs 4 years. One of them was a COVID qualifying round year, so it wasn't even really playoffs. He lost round one those 3 years that he actually made them. And other than that, he's been out of the playoffs, and he has not really been a good coach. And I mean, even in the AHL, he had 5 years of being the head coach in the AHL. He made the second round three to five times, and then made the third round twice. So not bad. But again, at the NHL level, in 8 years, he has not done really anything at all, which is not what you want to see. And before that, had 1 year as the assistant coach in the AHL for the same team he had been a head coach for with the Wilkes-Barre Scranton Penguins. And then had 2 years as an assistant coach for the University of Wisconsin. Had a 1 year assistant coach at the UMass Lowell. And other than that, I mean, he's just not a great coach. He's not a guy who I want being the next coach of the New York Rangers. At 48 years old, he has a decent amount of experience for his age, but I just don't think he's the best option. When you have a guy like Peter Laviolette, like I said, it just doesn't make any sense to go with a guy like John Hines, who has not done anything good at the NHL level. And I will not be happy if we see John Hines as the next head coach, but we'll have to wait and see. It seems like it's down to John Hines and Peter Laviolette. So hopefully we take Laviolette out of those two guys, because it's John Hines is not a guy I would want. I don't think many Rangers fans seem to want either, from what I've read and stuff on Twitter. But anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys have, please smash the like button. And don't forget to comment down below your guys' thoughts on John Hines potentially being the next Rangers head coach, because I definitely don't want to see that.